yeah, he had he'd been sending people to or candidates to West Point that were being rejected by the Commandant on a number of occasions. In 1932, he appointed Benjamin O. Davis to attend West Point. He had appointed a number of candidates before, and the Commandant in West Point had rejected all of them. So he finally launched an investigation into why they were being rejected. So when he finally confronted the Commandant said, "Well, frankly, Congressman, we don't want any Negro boys at West Point, and as fast as you send them here, we will send them back." DePriest replied, "Well, in that case, General, I will continue to send my boys up here smarter and blacker until you decide to accept one or lose your position." Davis was a graduate of the University of Chicago when he was appointed by DePriest to go to West Point. So he already had a four-year degree. So there was no doubting, you know, his academic prowess. He was, in fact, accepted at West Point. Now, when Benjamin Davis went there, unfortunately, he was shunned by all of his classmates for the full 4 years he attended West Point and was only spoken to when it was absolutely necessary by his classmates. He had no roommate, he ate alone, and he shared his pup tent with no other cadets for 4 years. His white classmates hoped this would cause him to quit, but it only steeled his resolve to graduate. When he did graduate, he was 35th out of a class of 278, and he was the only, he was the fourth black ever to graduate from West Point. Oscar DePriest was at his graduation, and then 2 weeks after that, he attended his wedding, which was also held at West Point. The West Point yearbook, the Howitzer, said of Davis, and I quote, "The courage, tenacity, and intelligence with which he conquered a problem incomparably more difficult than plebe year won for him the sincere admiration of his classmates, and his single-minded determination to continue in his chosen career cannot fail to inspire respect wherever fortune may lead him."